The development of safety design philosophies over the years has been critical to keeping aviation safe. But when we use terms such as Safelife or Failsafe, or say that loads are transferred from a failed component to a redundant part of the structure, what does that actually look like? My friend, Leah Lego, is a pilot, and she's going to help me demonstrate the differences between Safelife and Failsafe design philosophies. She's building herself a new plane from scratch, and she is going to join the rear part of one wing using a Safelife design, and the other with a Failsafe design. First, most of the fuselage still has to be built. And then it's onto the wings. On the left wing, there is a single orange block which will be connecting the rear piece. This is the Safelife design. And on the right wing, three smaller blocks are placed in the same area. This is the Failsafe design. And now for the final assembly and finishing touches, a quick inspection, and last but not least, the propeller installation. Now let's take a look at how each wing fares, starting with the Safelife design. Everything seems to go okay for the first several flights, but one day she encounters a gust of wind. It overloads the wing structure, causing the orange connector piece to fail. And unfortunately for Leah, she has also lost the rear section of her wing because that was the only attachment point. Definitely not good. Because it was designed for Safelife, the part was not intended to fail during its lifetime, and it wasn't able to handle the excess loading from the gust. Now let's see what happens with the Failsafe design of the right wing. Another gust of wind causes an overload, and one of the pieces came loose. But because of the Failsafe design, when the beige middle piece failed, the load that was being taken up by all three pieces has now been redistributed to the two remaining blue pieces. So lucky for Leah, the wing is still intact and she can land safely to repair her plane. And now that she's back on the ground, Leah's thinking it might be a good idea to replace the Safelife design with a Failsafe one. Fortunately, it's a pretty easy fix. And with that, she's ready to get back to the skies.